A question for Brad. In the spirit of Nouriel Roubini, could you talk about a worst case scenario for 2009, a possible sequence of events that would lead to a global financial meltdown, and what the if there would be something that the new U.S. administration could do to avoid that?
Well, you're a true optimist if you think we haven't already seen a global financial meltdown. I thought we came damn close. What could get worse? I think a couple of things could get worse. Oil prices could fall to 30, and commodity prices could fall significantly, leaving all the commodity exporters in a position where they are either running current account deficits or have to contract immediately. Eastern Europe could find that it can no longer finance any current account deficit and has to contract significantly. That feeds over into Europe. And this overall, and China's fiscal stimulus proves to be too small, and China investment demand inside China falls off a cliff, and China's current account surplus goes up, meaning that China is dumping a ton of goods onto the global market, and that is putting very strong deflationary pressure globally in a context of economic retrenchment in the commodity exporters and in those portions of the emerging world that had up until now been running current account deficits. That feeds back into the U.S., and you get an even more significant slowdown in the advanced economies than the IMF is now forecasting. The IMF is now forecasting kind of flat to slightly negative growth in the advanced economies and reasonably positive, although not at that high growth in the emerging world. This would be a scenario where growth in the advanced economies becomes significantly negative, growth in the emerging world comes close to zero, and we get negative global growth for the first time in a very long time. So I don't know if that's Nouriel Roubini-esque, but it's my best effort.
Do you guys practice telling these scary stories?
You know, the world would have been a lot better off if a lot more people had been thinking about scary stories 2 years ago. If risk managers in major financial institutions had stress tested a really simple idea that home prices might fall by 20% on a nationwide basis and said, you know, maybe we shouldn't gear our entire institution, bet our entire equity base on the assumption that home prices won't fall by that much, even though they've gone up by a lot more, maybe we wouldn't be in this current situation. So yeah, we're good at coming up with doomsday bad scenarios. But risk managers is about cutting off the tail. It's about avoiding the really bad outcome. And in order to avoid the really bad outcome, you have to be able to imagine it. Sorry.
That's what?
Well, this is World War III.
Sorry. Can I-